There's an interesting paradox in A/B testing, and the more years I spend in the field, the more clearly I see this. The paradox is this. Experiments help you make decisions more objectively, but there are so many elements in them that will always be very subjective. The simplest example for that is calculating statistical significance. It's plain science, right? There's a formula, you use it, you get your results, there's no room for opinions. Or actually, there is. Even in something as objective as statistics, there's a place for subjective opinions. Remember that I said that you have to choose the right level of statistical significance, 90%, 95%, 99%, or something else, in your A/B tests based on your risk tolerance. Now, risk tolerance is often a question of emotions rather than logic. Or another example could be the thing I mentioned in a previous video where I talked about the limitations of A/B testing. I said that you have to use multiple research methods to get a clearer picture about the subject of your research. Take the example of creating a cohort analysis. Creating a cohort analysis of your data is the science part, right? But then how you interpret the results you get and how do you decide what's important and what's not, that's very subjective. Often when I do data analysis and I show my results to 5 different people at a company, I get 2 or 3 different interpretations of the very same analysis. And I find this very fascinating because this duality of facts and opinions comes up in so many places in data science, and especially when you run experiments. What do you want to A/B test? What research methods do you use to prepare your test? How do you measure your results? How do you interpret the data you get? What's important? What's not? The answers to all these questions rely mostly on logic. That's true. But in each of the answers, there will be bits that are based on best practices, intuitions, and opinions. So there is a part of A/B testing that's more like an art than a science. The more A/B tests you will run, the more clearly you will see this too. What I want to say with this is that in this course, besides the science part, the facts and the logical and rational things, I showed you many things that are my best practices based on my experience and my business thinking. And if you ask other data professionals, maybe they will think about these things slightly differently, and they will approach the same problem from a slightly different angle. And that's great. All the things you have learned in this course will serve you as a solid foundation to run your own A/B tests, but I also encourage you to read other data professionals' articles, listen to A/B test expert speeches, go to meetups and conferences and exchange thoughts, ideas, and best practices with other people who run A/B tests frequently. After the course, don't stop learning and keep widening your perspective. In the extra section of this module, I've collected a few resources that I find very inspiring and that I think you should go through too so you can see more point of views on the topic.